There is a new report coming from Asia which claims that Tesla's upcoming Model 3, the refreshed Model 3, will feature CATL's new battery, which is longer range. It's going to give the new Model 3 longer range. Welcome back, everyone. And it's an LFP battery. This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, please take a moment and subscribe to our channel because I'm going to bring you very interesting couple of news stories this couple of days. So Tesla's upcoming new refreshed Model 3 is rumored to feature CATL's new M3P LFP cells, which should result in a longer range. For almost a year now, we have been talking about Tesla working on a refresh of its Model 3 electric sedan. It's called Project Highland. Much of the talk around the refresh has been focused on the design, but Tesla is expected to make some updates under the hood as well. Now, a new report coming from Asia tech media 36KR, that's a publication, claims that we now know that it will feature new battery cells. The Model 3 will feature new longer range battery cells. The publication claims Tesla will use CATL's new M3P cell to create a new 66 kilowatt hour battery pack. And if I translate that from the KR36KR, it sounds like this. 36 Krypton learned from a number of people familiar with the matter that Tesla's domestically made Model 3 facelift will continue to upgrade the battery pack, especially the power of the basic rear-wheel drive version will be upgraded from 60 kilowatt hour to 66 kilowatt hour using Ninja Area M3P new lithium iron phosphate battery. Friends, this new battery cell from CATL is believed to push LFP energy density higher while reducing costs. It should enable approximately 6 kilowatt hour bump in the total energy inside Tesla's base battery pack, which should result in a longer range. This is going to give some peace for people who are worried about range anxiety when driving electric cars and particularly Tesla. So as we reported last year that CATL was bringing the new M3P cells to volume production in 2023 for deliveries to customers. We have lots of reports on that at TorqueNews.com and at the Torque News YouTube channel. CATL has become one of Tesla's main battery manufacturers in recent years, especially for vehicles produced in Gigafactory Shanghai. If you may know, or if you don't know, CATL is the largest battery producer, electric vehicle battery producer in the world. So let me know your thoughts. Are you excited about this new battery that is going to be used, M3P CATL battery that is going to have longer range, about six more kilowatt hour energy, and lots of goodies? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section, friends. Let's continue the discussion there. I'd like to hear what you have to say. Maybe I'll do another report on this. God bless you. See you soon in our next report. There is a new solid-state battery for electric cars, which is going to be able to increase a Tesla Model Y's range to 600 miles on a single charge. This is developed by a company called Prolonguim, which is Mercedes-Benz partner. And later this year, it's going to be given to sampling with OEMs, like I said, later this year. And I'm about to tell you, if this is all true, by the end of this year, you may hear news that Tesla Model Y can go 600 miles on a single charge because of this new solid-state battery. Welcome back, everyone. This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, please take a moment to subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla news and ring the bell before I tell you this story. The Mercedes-Benz partner in solid-state battery development, Prolonguim, will be demonstrating a new technology called large footprint lithium ceramic battery that can double the volumetric energy density of the Tesla Model Y's 2170 battery pack. The LLCB battery will be sampling with OEMs later this year, according to notebookcheck.net. After announcing the first solid-state battery cell with 100% silicon oxide anode, Mercedes partner Prolonguim used the ongoing EES Expo to demonstrate a new solid-state battery pack structure that offers even higher energy density. called large footprint lithium ceramic battery. The new design is I will refer to it as LLCB, large footprint lithium ceramic battery. The new design does for solid state batteries what? Increasing the cell size from the 2170 to the 4680 standard did for current EV packs. That's what this new battery does. The flat shape of the LLCB cell, coupled with the high thermal conductivity of the ceramic electrolyte used in solid state batteries, allow for a more compact cooling system. At the same time, the larger cell size means less parallel connections. All of those design advancements drastically increase the volumetric density of the new solid-state battery, as per the Assistant Vice President of Prolongwin Technology Product Center, Simon Wu. This is what he said. He said, for the same space as the mainstream 2170 EV battery pack, the LLCB pack's volumetric energy density can be nearly doubled, and for the same total energy. The LLCB pack's weight can be cut by up to 115 kilograms. More importantly, the LLCB production process will produce less waste in terms of substrate materials, and the reduced number of cells will require less raw materials, which means increased sustainability and affordability. What this means is that a Tesla Model Y long range, for instance, which is currently powered by 2170 cells, will be able to go 79% further as per the promo video below, which is accompanying here. That's nearly 600 miles of range on a charge with the same battery pack footprint if there are LLCB cells inside. A hypothetical Model Y battery made by Prolongwin would also be lighter and its production more sustainable. Prolongwin, which recently announced a $5.2 billion solid-state battery factory in France, will be sampling its new LLCB cells with European carmakers like Mercedes-Benz later this year. The planned capacity of the solid-state battery factory in Dunkirk is for 48 gigawatt-hour of annual output, which will be deployed in several phases. This is very exciting. If things go this way, by the end of the year, we may see a Tesla Model Y with 600 miles of range on a single charge. What do you make of it, friends? And this is a very serious company. They're making multi-billion dollar battery factories like the one in France. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla and electric vehicle news. God bless you, and I'll see you soon in our next report. I have a breaking news about Tesla's 4680 battery cell production, friends. Just about an hour ago, Tesla announced a major milestone in 4680 cell ramp at Gigafactory Texas. Welcome back, everyone. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, please take a moment and subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla news and ring the bell so you don't miss my next coverage. So Tesla just about an hour ago announced a major milestone in the ramp of the 4680 battery cell at Gigafactory Texas, confirming it has produced 10 million battery cells at the plant. Imagine 10 million 4680 battery cells at Gigafactory Texas. Tesla has been building 4680 cells for several years after unveiling the technology behind the battery in late 2020. Initially starting production at the Cato Road facility in Northern California, just near the Fremont factory, Tesla expanded 4680 manufacturing at Gigafactory Texas after vehicle production began and has been using the batteries in the all-wheel drive Model Y. Tesla has been selling these Model Ys for over a year now, and the ramp-up of 4680 technology has continued. After aiming to begin production of 4680 cells in quarter 3 2022, Tesla has evidently ramped the manufacturing of the battery up considerably, announcing it has built 10 million cells in Gigafactory Texas earlier today. Like I said, just about an hour ago. The 10 million cells produced are enough to build roughly 12,000 Model Y vehicles. Don't think that these 10 million cells, meaning 10 million enough batteries for 10 million vehicles. No, the 10 million battery cells produced are enough to build roughly 12,000 Model Y vehicles. Outside of Texas, Tesla is hoping to continue ramping up 4680 production to supplement vehicles that will be fitted with those packs. In Fremont, California, Tesla just leased a massive 210,000 plus square foot facility that will be used for 4680 manufacturing, helping to get more cars with the breakthrough battery technology on the road. It's a huge building. Last year, CEO of Tesla, Elon Musk, said 4680 battery cells would be an important part of Tesla's plans in 2023. Evidently, ramping up production of these cells and getting more 4680 packs into the company's electric vehicle is a goal moving forward, and hopefully Tesla can reach a point where they are not limited with how many vehicles they can build, as cell constraints have been an industry-wide issue for years. So I congratulate Tesla for this milestone and for building more 4680 batteries for their vehicles. And I think this by next year, we should see more numbers, better numbers coming up from Tesla in this regard. What do you think, friends? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below.